Do you want to enable or disable core isolation and memory integrity in Windows 11 or 10? Then you are at the right place as we have the ways to fix the issue. Let's get started. This is the Windows Club. Core isolation is a security feature in Windows that protects important core processes of Windows from malicious software by isolating them in memory, by running those core processes in a virtualized environment. Core isolation features include memory integrity and kernel mode hardware enforced stack protection. Here is how to enable or disable core isolation and memory integrity in Windows. Let's get started. Method 1. Enable core isolation and memory integrity in Windows 11 or 10. Sign in as an administrator and open Windows Defender Security Center. Look for Device Security option. Here, you should check if core isolation under virtualization is enabled on your PC. Core isolation provides virtualization-based security feature to protect core parts of your device. Click on Core Isolation Details and you will be offered to enable memory integrity. Memory integrity is a security feature of core isolation that prevents attacks from inserting malicious code into high security processes. Toggle to turn it on. Once enabled, it will ask you to restart the PC to completely enable memory integrity. If later on you face application compatibility issues, you may need to turn this off. Method 2. Enable or disable core isolation and memory integrity using registry. Press Win plus R to open the Run dialog. Type regedit and hit the Enter button. Navigate to scenarios in hkey_local_machine following this path: computer/hkey_local_machine/system/current_control_set/control/device_guard/scenarios. Right-click on scenarios, then select New, then Key. Name it as Hypervisor Enforced Code Integrity. Right-click on it, then select New, then DWORD 32-bit value. Name it as Enabled. Double-click on it to set the value data as 1 to enable and 0 to disable. Click the OK button. Restart your computer. Before heading to the regedit steps, don't forget to create a system restore point following this guide. So that's it. Subscribe to the Windows Club for all your tech solutions related to Windows. Thanks for watching.